All right, everyone, we are going to get started here. About 10 seconds. If someone could give me a shout out or a hand raise that they can hear me okay. I'm sure that everything's good. I see one. All right. I think we're good. See Paige Brown. What's up? I think that was a hand raise. Misty McIntosh. Yeah. All right. Got hand raises all over the place. Love it. Myrna, Donna. Yes. So everybody can hear me okay. Angie Johnson in the house. Thanks for joining me. Let's get started here in about 10 minutes. Can everybody see me? I don't know if you guys, depending upon where you are at. Yes. All right. Thanks, Patricia. Really appreciate that. All right. So let's get going here. I want to start this off by, before we kind of dive into this intro, I'd like to read something. It's one of my favorite things. I read it at the last intro. I'm going to read it on here. It's called The Man in the Arena. It's from Teddy Roosevelt. It's not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming. But who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither know victory nor defeat. I actually want to get, that's from Teddy Roosevelt, one of his speeches way back in the day. I want to get daring greatly tattooed somewhere because, you know, I tell you what, daring greatly in a sales job is what we do every day. We get out of our comfort zone. So that's why I really love this little speech. I love starting it for at least the intros. We might talk about it in the actual webinar. But thank you for joining me on Introduction to Lead Generation Without Limits. I'm extremely excited to be here with you guys today. So we're going to kind of go through this. I'll run through a quick intro. But before I do the intro even, I do want to start a story. Yesterday, I was lead generating with another gentleman from another market center. Actually, he was coming in to shadow our team, and we were lead genning, and it was awesome. We do 3-hour blocks, which we'll talk about time blocking, of course, in the course, but 9:30 to 12:30 is our lead gen block. And so yesterday we're sitting here lead genning and grinding. I mean, we're about 2.5 hours in, and you know, we're not really getting anything, and we're just rustling a bunch of trees, all different kinds of leads and online leads and cold calling and you name it, we're doing it. And so anyways, him and I were ending it with cold calling, and I'm a firm believer in the sales gods, because you know, about 2 hours and 45 minutes in, I'll be dang, it happens every time. It was very, very strange, actually. We were cold calling a neighborhood, and all of a sudden, we're talking to one of the neighbors, and we're saying, hey, do you know anyone else that would be interested in maybe selling their home? And this was through the conversation. And as we're saying that, because we're using a dialer, which we'll talk about in the course, but we're using a dialer, as we're saying that, the gentleman that he brings up calls us back from a previous call. You know, and we can't take it because we're on this other line. And I just thought, this is so weird. This is the universe looking down on us. We called him back after the call ended, and we said, hey, you know, he does want to sell. And it was a very, very good call. So anyways, the point there is that you're grinding and grinding and grinding through lead gen. And I tell you what, the sales gods are always looking down on you. So Intro to Lead Gen Without Limits. Let's get into this. My name is Joey Torkildson. I am the CEO and realtor at the HergGroup North Suburban. I'm actually part of Hergenrother Realty Group, which is one of the expansion teams. If any of you went to family reunion with Keller Williams recently in Anaheim, California, it was awesome. You might have seen Adam, the visionary of our team, on stage. Actually, he was in one of the breakout sessions with Gary Keller and the 5 top expansion teams. And Adam Hergenrother was up there. It was awesome. I'm very grateful to be partnered with him. Actually, just a quick stat. In January, we did 75 units, $19 million in volume. So we are rocking and rolling into 2018. So let's kind of dive into this. You know, lead generation is such a big part of any sales business, right? It's crucial. It's the lifeblood. Because if you don't have any leads, if you don't have any people to work with, well, then you're unemployed, right? You're especially with commission-only sales. You don't have anything going on. You have to sell to eat. And to sell to eat, you need leads. And you need a good lead generation habit. And so we're going to kind of talk about that. So let's go into this a little bit. All right, so what we're going to cover in Lead Generation Without Limits, which it starts on Thursday. So if you guys are interested, and we're going to dive into this way, way, way more in depth, because it's a four-part series. And so please get signed up for that after this call. So what we're going to cover, lead generation tactics. So it's really, we're not going to necessarily reinvent the wheel. We are going to talk about the different strategies and tactics for each of kind of the main, what I kind of call the main spokes of lead generation. We're not going to go crazy with bells and whistles and all this nuts stuff that, you know, it's so funny when we're at family reunion, right? When we're at family reunion, we're walking around the vendor fair and people spending tons of money on all these things. And really, it's not that difficult. So we're going to go into strategies with your sphere of influence. How can you actually generate more business from your own tribe, from your own people? We're going to go into cold calls. Cold calls and emails, it's still a very good strategy. Now, everybody's all, it's so funny. I was talking to an agent today. I was going to do some broker opens for my lead generation, actually. And we were talking, and I would never cold call. And we'll talk about how cold calling can present so many opportunities, because there's opportunities everywhere, right? We just have to find them. And same thing with emails. We'll talk about social media, the tactics with social media. What can we do? We'll dive into it and go, hey, let's hone in on a really good strategy. And then, of course, door knocking. That's a classic, right? But what can we do to up the ante on our door knocking? Get in front of people. Find those opportunities. We're also going to – here's the thing. With lead generation without limits, right, we go back to the basics. If you guys noticed, anybody that did get a chance to go to family reunion, and if you didn't, I would highly recommend it, by the way. But if – you know, all of the mega, mega top producers, right – there wasn't anything crazy. It was a very systematic, simple system. So we're going to talk sales 101. We're going to go lead gen back to the basics and keep it easy. We're going to go dive into best prospecting habits. It's really all a habit. In fact, your lead generation habit, okay, should actually become two things. It should become boring. You should actually be bored with it. You should go, oh my gosh, you know, I'm doing this lead gen habit again. That's when you know you're getting somewhere. And the second thing is, when you don't do it, your day should feel extremely strange. I've been doing it now for years. And so we have this morning lead gen habit. And so now when I don't do it, all of a sudden it's strange. I'm like, oh my gosh, again, and it's like my day is off. Okay. So we're going to talk about best prospecting habits, how to follow up, and why perseverance pays off. We talk about a lot of stories with that, okay? Because numerous times, I actually just had one. I was showing, this was just yesterday again with this individual. Although it didn't turn into an appointment, I had actually spoken with this person for the last 2 years. We got introduced 2 years ago. They were a seller. They decided not to sell. And every time I call now, she answers the phone and says, hey, Joey. You know, and it's this great conversation, and she is going to actually do something, and she loves. She goes, keep calling me, and I'm like, and I showed the gentleman I was with yesterday. I said, look at this. I've literally called her. It was, you know, something crazy, 20 times or something. So perseverance pays off. We're going to go into that, and of course, I know you got everyone, especially if you're with Keller Williams. If you're not, it doesn't matter. If you're in sales, time blocking for lead generation success, and the power of saying no. That is our best word, right? Because when you're lead generating, if you're constantly getting interrupted, constantly getting distracted, lead generation takes focus and it takes presence, right? You have to be where you are when you're there. And lead generation is no different. You have to be present, and time blocking can really help with that. And then, of course, systems for lead conversion. The key is that, okay, you're going to get this lead. You're going to generate the lead. It's going to be awesome. Great. I got this lead and they want to do something. Cool. Here's the thing. Now you have to convert them into someone actually doing something, right? That's the hardest part. So, well, I mean, I shouldn't say that's the hardest part. You know, generating the lead, that's one step. and then actually converting the lead, that's the next step. So one of the key things we talk about is the power of follow-up, obviously. That is a key aspect of things, right? That's where the big money is made. The good, the decent money is made lead generating. The big money is made in follow-up. So we're going to talk about systems for actually converting the leads. So that's that. Okay, how to be a lead generator without limits. Here's the thing, you guys, okay? Where the magic happens is not in your comfort zone. I don't know if you've seen this little graphic before. It was one of my favorite. I love just looking at this because I have to remind myself daily, you know, asking people for business, asking people for different opportunities, it's difficult. It's one of the hardest things. We call it the power of the ask, right? It's very, very hard. You have to remove yourself from what I call your warm fuzzies, your PJs, whatever you want to call it. You have to kind of remove yourself from that. And you really do have to get out of your comfort zone when you're lead generating, because there's been numerous times, and I'm sure some of you have been here. If not, I'm sure you will be if you're a newer agent on this call right now. But you know, where you're having this great conversation and then the conversation ends and you never asked for business. And actually this was probably a year ago or so, I was actually door knocking for one of the agents on my team. He was doing the open house. I said, you know, I'm going to go door knock and try to drive some neighbor traffic over there. Well, it was hilarious. So about three doors down, I had talked to somebody and they said, you know what? We do want to sell. And I had this great conversation and it was awesome. And then I never got their contact information. And I walked back to where the open house was. I said, I had this great conversation. You know, I'm going to have to follow up with them. He goes, did you get the contact info? I said, no, I didn't get it. He goes, what do you mean? I said, I guess I don't know. I don't know why. And I ended up, you know what he said? Why don't you just walk back there? So that was totally uncomfortable because now all of a sudden I had to walk back and go, hey, you know what? By the way, I didn't get any of your contact info. And guess what? They gave me everything. They gave me their name, their number, their email. Obviously, I had their address because I knew where the house was. And it was, next thing you know, it was about a month later, we listed their house. We helped them buy. It was awesome. But I never got their contact information because I was afraid to ask. Or maybe I wasn't afraid, but I just didn't think of it. And I kind of just faded off into the sunset. And next thing you know, I didn't have anything from it. So we have to get ourselves out of our comfort zone. And so we will go into that. Okay. What's our job description, right? So obviously it all starts. I mean, we have all the noise. We have negotiating with clients. We have negotiating deals, showing products, showing the homes, selling the product, actually doing our job, right? Maybe you're in an open house and you're actually selling the home to buyers, but it all starts with lead generating and then lead follow-up, right? Without those two, you're not doing anything. And it's funny sometimes. I actually, you know, I look around the office and it's hilarious because every once in a while I'll see people and I'm like, what are you doing? Playing a mean game of office, organizing their desk. I mean, if you saw my desk and you saw my office, it's a disaster. This part's neat, actually, for those of you who can see. This is my wife. She made this little setup. It's awesome. So, but here's the thing. My desk, it's a disaster. Why? Because here's the thing. You cannot play a mean game of office, right? You need to lead generate, lead follow up, and then go lock stuff down. That's the key. So if you don't do that right now, we're going to dive into that and why it's important and why you can actually instill this habit and why it's going to help you in your business, okay? So what are the habits of really good lead generators? Lead generators without any limits, okay? It happens before anything. Lead generation happens before anything. Procrastination does not occur with this. Now, here's why I say that. In our business, especially in real estate, there is nothing that happens in real estate in the morning. You think it's going to happen, but it's so easy to dive into fires first thing in the morning. So easy. You got a deal blowing up. You got something going on. And next thing you know, that thing will consume you. The best lead generators without limits that always have a full pipeline, make sure to get it done first thing. Now, we have a 3-hour lead gen habit. Not everybody wants to do that. Not everybody can do that. But maybe it's 1 hour. Maybe you start with 1 hour. Maybe you start with 2 hours. But here's the thing. The habit needs to start before anything, all right? Lead generators without limits, they don't make excuses, and they sure as heck don't complain. Now, I tell you what. It's easy to go down that path. It's easy, it's hard to cold call. It's easy to complain when someone yells at you. We're getting yelled at all the time. I got yelled at this morning, a couple times. I got yelled at and hung up on it. It was hilarious. I laughed it off, but you know, here's the thing. I didn't complain. I said, hey, you know what? You know what I actually said after this person yelled at me and hung up? I said, oh, you know what? I can't help that person. It was very simple, very easy, right? To do that. I got to do a little self-talk every once in a while. Anyways, they create golden hours, time blocked hours that are protected. For those who have not read The One Thing, I highly recommend it. He talks about building a bunker, and you got to protect your time. You got to be focused, because that is where you are generating your lifeblood, your pipeline, okay? They're fanatical. Here's the thing, lead generators without limits, fanatical prospectors, fanatical, the definition of fanatical, motivated or characterized by an extreme or uncritical enthusiasm, okay? The lead generation hat just never comes off. Now, some might say, oh, that's so overwhelming. Now I got to be working all the time. Here's the thing. That's where the fun part is that we have the opportunity to find stuff all over the place, find opportunities left, right, center. They're everywhere. I was actually, 2 weeks ago, I was out to breakfast with someone. I was wearing this huge name tag. For those of you that can see this, I wear this everywhere. And I was out to breakfast with a friend. We were having a great conversation. It was a chill breakfast. And of course, the waitress, she started talking about my name tag. Next thing you know, we're diving into a real estate conversation. It's that simple. Was I working? I mean, I didn't really consider myself working, so my guard was down, but I was working. My radar was on. It was still there, right? So here's the thing. The lead generation hat really never comes off, because as soon as it does, you're going to miss out on an opportunity, because they're everywhere, okay? And now, lead generators without limits, they lead gen when times are good, and they lead gen when times are bad. It's really easy once your pipeline is full, because here's the thing. After the 4 weeks that we're going to rock out together, you're going to be doing this, right? You're going to be rocking out this habit. You're going to get leads. And all of a sudden, you're going to have appointments. And then those appointments are going to turn into clients. And next thing you know, you're going to have a full schedule. The easiest thing to do is see times are good. I got deals. I got a pipeline. And then all of a sudden, you stop lead gen. Well, guess what? We all know how this works. That stuff can disappear just like that. So it's important to, of course, you're going to double the lead gen when times are bad. And then when times are good, you just maintain that habit, just like working out. Okay. So that's the habits of really, really good lead generators. Okay. And we're going to dive into that even more. Okay. So this starts on Thursday, I think is March 1st. What it is. So here's how it's going to roll. Weekly 1 hour sessions. So we're going to do it for 4 weeks. We're going to dive into, we're going to really go in depth with really good strategies. It's going to help you guys get more business. We're also going to create a private Facebook group for sharing ahas, asking questions, engaging, masterminding with myself. I'll be in there. And, you know, I love diving into that. Masterminding is such an important part of this. So if there's questions of any kind, and by the way, if you do have questions about the course, you can type those in and toss those out right now, and I'll get to those in 1 second. So we're going to have a private Facebook group. You're going to have access to all the recordings, so you can look back if you need something to pump you up later on and go, oh, yeah, that's right. I got to rock this out. You know, you'll always be able to go back and take a look at those. And then bonus materials after every session, because we're going to talk about different systems that we use. This is not a pitch for any of those systems, but it's certain things that we've done that might help you guys. And if it's something you want to look into down the road, we can get you connected with the right people there. So are there any questions at all? Please send them out. This starts March 1st, 2 p.m. Eastern time, depending upon where everybody is. Because here's the thing, you guys. Opportunities really are everywhere. So if you do want to create more opportunities for yourself and grow your business in 2018, what are we? Are we 2 months in? 60 days. We're 60 days in. Look at where your business is. Is it where you want it to be? If it's not, now's the time. Turn up the dial. I remember this. What was that old school movie? Spinal Tap. You turn up the dial to 11 or whatever. But that is what this course is developed to do, to kind of slap you upside the head and go, let's go. Let's amp this up. You'll be able to take things out of this, actionable items that you can use in your own strategy. So, or in your own daily lead gen. So please, please, please join me March 1st. Get signed up. There's the link. You'll also get the recording. If you have any questions, see that email there down below. If you have any questions at all, just email us and we'll fill you in, or just get signed up and we will see you guys in a few days. Thanks for joining me. Really, really appreciate it. Any questions? Any questions last minute? I think we're looking good. Awesome, guys. Thank you. Really appreciate you joining me here.